The sandwich is quite alright, but that bread certainly is interesting. The coffee is well made, just the right strength that you want in your coffee. Hi folks, we're on the Mysore-Bangalore highway and we're driving towards Bangalore. We've just crossed Mandya and we're approaching Maddur shortly. Now, a few days ago, the world of coffee lost one of its greatest ambassadors, Mr. V G Siddhartha, the founder of Cafe Coffee Day. I'm sure to most of you across the country, Cafe Coffee Day is much more than a spot where you just go and grab a coffee. Like many of you, I've experienced Cafe Coffee Day for many years now, from the time that they first opened their first cafe in 96. I've seen Cafe Coffee Day grow as a brand over the last 23 years. And of course, I've drunk many a coffee at the various CCD outlets across the country. So I thought it would be fitting to do a special episode as a tribute to Mr. V. G. Siddhartha and the legacy that he leaves behind in the world of coffee. One Americano, tandoori chicken sandwich kodi. Cafe Coffee Day always has the friendliest of people serving you, and I think that's what makes it even nicer, because especially when you're on the highway, you've been driving, you've been riding for a while, and then you come across a Cafe Coffee Day. Wherever you are, when you want that cup of coffee or when you want to just stop, take a break, you want to catch up with somebody, you know, over a cup of coffee, you immediately start looking for a Cafe Coffee Day, because you know there will be a Cafe Coffee Day somewhere around you. And that's such a remarkable journey from the time that the first Cafe Coffee Day was established in 1996. I remember it clearly because 96 is the year that I moved to Bangalore. And at that time, Cafe Coffee Day, I don't know if it was called Cafe Coffee Day or was it called Coffee Day, I'm not very sure. But they had an outlet on Brigade Road, that was the first cafe. And the interesting thing here was that this was an internet cafe. Today we take the World Wide Web and internet for granted. Everybody's got the net on their phone, right? We've got 4G connections, we're heading into 5G. But back then, getting access to the internet was a big thing. And that too, getting access to the internet and, you know, sipping on a cup of coffee while you were browsing the net, checking your mail or whatsoever. Thank you. I've ordered the Americano. The coffee is well made. Just the right strength. That you want in your coffee. It's also got a, you know, slightly fruity character. I've also got myself a tandoori chicken sandwich in a multigrain bread. Of course, these are not exactly gourmet sandwiches, but I think the food has certainly come a long way. You know, the bread in itself looks very interesting, studded with all sorts of healthy speckles. You've got the flax seeds, you've got the oats, perhaps some pumpkin seeds. It's my first meal of the day, so it's only fitting that I have bread. The sandwich is quite alright, but that bread certainly is interesting. I think what Cafe Coffee Day did was, it made the act of drinking coffee fashionable. So coffee got transformed from something that your parents drank or something that your uncle drank to something that was hip, something that became cool. And I think in a way, Cafe Coffee Day really brought about that whole culture of drinking and appreciating coffee. It took a drink that was perceived to be an older person's fuddy-duddy beverage to something that became very hip and very cool. I also remember when, you know, I started Food Lovers, or when I was mulling Food Lovers and we were planning it all together, we didn't have money for an office. We didn't have an office actually. So Cafe Coffee Day would become the office, would become the place where we would meet. So Cafe Coffee Day was where we did a lot of planning as we set up Food Lovers. And I'm sure that's also the case for many people with Cafe Coffee Day. I think it's a place where a lot of things got planned, where a lot of ideas got planned, which eventually led to large corporations. So most of you know that I love motorcycling, and you know, I like to motorcycle long distances. Now when you're riding out, you're riding in the sun, it's hot, sometimes you're riding through the rain, sometimes it's cold. So every once in a while, every few hours, you want to take a break. And when you want to take a break, you want to look for a place that's conducive to taking a break, where you know your motorcycles are going to be safe, where you can relax a bit, perhaps enjoy some great coffee, nibble on something. So when we find that Coffee Day sign, it's always a, you know, we always heave a sigh of relief because we know we can go there and relax for a bit before commencing on the ride. So over the last many years, I've enjoyed countless cups of coffee over many, many experiences at Cafe Coffee Day. And the tagline for Cafe Coffee Day says, a lot can happen over coffee. Well, at least for me, and I'm sure for many of you out there, a lot indeed has happened over coffee at Cafe Coffee Day. So here's to the legacy that you leave behind, Mr. Siddhartha, in Cafe Coffee Day.